But first, the story that we are tracking at the moment, those images that are playing on your television screen, because Dhanteras today has not been lucky for all, especially for traders in Faridabad near the national capital. A firecracker market in the city has gone up, making it look like an early firework display on Diwali. The result of a fire sparked by a short circuit in one of the 200 shops that have now been completely gutted. No casualty has been reported so far, but we are still waiting for clarity to emerge on just how many people have been injured. Latest reports saying 5 people have suffered serious injuries, some of them in a stampede that has followed the fire. Those images that you can see, clearly dramatic, when 200 shops, cracker shops, explode in that manner. Atir Khan is tracking that story. He joins us. Atir, please tell us, is the situation now under control? Has the fire department been able to douse the flames?
Well, Rajdeep, at least 2 dozen fire tenders were pressed into service, and some private fire tenders were also brought in to bring the situation under control. Now the fire has been doused to a great extent, but then the fire spread so quickly that the people who were there at the spot tried to rush to safety, and it was those people who sustained burn injuries. Now, they have been hospitalized at the civil hospital, but we know that the issue is that there is still a blanket of smoke over that region, which is causing health problems, and people are finding it difficult to breathe in that area, Rajiv.
But what we want to know is the fire completely now being brought under control, as some were suggesting it will be brought under control sooner rather than later?
Well, Rajdeep, it will take a while before it is brought under complete control. But yes, the major fire has been doused, but then the cooling operation will continue, it seems, overnight. It will take, since there were 200 shops,
right.
The operation is still on here at the Dashara ground.
Okay, Atir Khan, appreciate your joining us, giving us the very latest from Faridabad, where that terrible fire has taken place, causing an inferno. Those images that you can still see on your screen. Let's hope that there are no casualties at the end of this evening. Okay, let's then turn straight to state politics and the state of Maharashtra, because we still don't know at the end of the Maha verdict who will be the Chief Minister of Maharashtra and what form will the government take. Nitin Gadkari is now being suddenly projected as a potential Chief Minister after he was welcomed in almost euphoric Chief Ministerial style when he returned to Nagpur this evening. That's the indication also coming in from BJP MLA and former State Union President Sudhir Mungantiwar, who has told headlines today that Gadkari should be appointed as the Chief Minister of Maharashtra. The decision, however, has been delayed and is now expected to be only made after Diwali. But clearly, there is much going on within the BJP.
मैं बिल्कुल नहीं बनूंगा, मैं दावेदार भी नहीं हूं और मैं बनना भी नहीं चाहता हूं, कहने के बाद भी नहीं बनना चाहता हूं। मेरा प्रश्न है, मैं दिल्ली में हूं, जब मैं दिल्ली जाना नहीं चाहता था तब गया हूं, अब दिल्ली में मुझे जो काम मिला हुआ है मैं बहुत खुश हूं।
नितिन जी ने यहां आना चाहिए या नहीं तो सबको लगता है उन्होंने आना चाहिए। अब उन्होंने मना कर दिया है, अब मना करने के बाद क्या होगा? तो पार्लियामेंट्री बोर्ड विधायक दल की बैठक होगी, विधायकों से पूछा जाएगा।
Okay, let me go straight across to Sahil Joshi, our Mumbai bureau chief, who joins us. Sahil, till yesterday it seemed like a done deal that Devendra Fadnavis would be the next Chief Minister of Maharashtra. Now we are learning two things. A, the BJP may go in for a minority government, may even take outside support of the Shiv Sena if necessary. And Nitin Gadkari is suddenly the front runner for Chief Minister. Please give us a sense of what actually is happening in Mumbai.
See, as far as Nitin Gadkari's name is concerned, it's now pretty clear that there is a inside war within the BJP on the chief minister's position, because it looks like that the stalwarts, the seniors in BJP, in the state BJP, they are not agreeing to work under the new face in BJP, may it Devendra Fadnavis or any other one. So they think that Nitin Gadkari will be the obvious choice because they will not have any problem with that. Two, they know that it's a minority government. They will have to take support from Shiv Sena, or they will have to be with the outside support with NCP. So they think that Nitin Gadkari is the one who can handle such kind of things.
Right.
No one else can do that. So suddenly Nitin Gadkari's name has come up.
There was one more point that I wanted to bring in, because I've just got an SMH to say Shiv Sena surrenders. I'm not able to understand what it means Shiv Sena surrenders. There's talk that Uddhav Thackeray is going to fly into Delhi either tomorrow or after Diwali. Am I to understand that there will be now a BJP Shiv Sena government, and therefore once a BJP Shiv Sena government comes, will the equation for a chief minister change? Will Gadkari be the chief minister only if it's a minority government? What are you getting a sense? Is the Shiv Sena now surrendering before the BJP?
See, at this point of time, Shiv Sena has appointed two of its leaders to go to Delhi and speak to Rajnath Singh and JP Nadda, who is newly appointed in charge of Maharashtra BJP. But the second thing is that some people from Shiv Sena are also saying that Uddhav Thackeray will also go to Delhi and meet with the Prime Minister. But I'm surprised because Prime Minister himself will be coming to Mumbai to inaugurate Ambani Hospital on Saturday. Despite that, I spoke to Uddhav Thackeray in the evening. He said that he will not be going to Delhi. He has not yet decided about it. So that means there is a thought going on in Shiv Sena that they will have to go to Delhi and speak to the top leaders rather than speaking to the people here before Rajnath Singh and JP Nadda arrives in Mumbai to finalize that who will be the legislative party leader in Maharashtra. Now, Shiv Sena is still stuck to the proposal of 1995, where if the chief minister is of BJP, the portfolios like home, PWD and irrigation goes to the other party, that is now Shiv Sena, and the deputy chief ministership. Whereas BJP has clearly told Shiv Sena that that is not going to be happening, because in 95, the difference between the BJP and Shiv Sena seats were not even 10 right. seats. Whereas today, BJP is doubled the seats of that of Shiv Sena. So they think that it is not going to happen. That BJP has told Shiv Sena that they are not going to have a bigger cabinet. They are going to have cabinet ministers of around 12 to 14. So in that situation, they will not be able to share plump portfolios to Shiv Sena. So Shiv Sena will have to agree whatever the BJP gives to them. So if Shiv Sena wants to be part of this government, so the only choice to them is to speak to Rajnath Singh or JP Nadda and try to convince them that how it will be better if Shiv Sena is part of the government with the satisfaction rather than being out of the government. So that is what is happening. But the important thing is that before that, there is an inside war within BJP over the chief ministership, and it looks like that people are not agreeing to only Devendra Fadnavis, and the Gadkari camp is also active to bring in their own person in the chief ministership.
Let's not forget Nitin Gadkari has an excellent relationship also with Sharad Pawar, who has already offered unconditional support to this government. So clearly Nitin Gadkari now emerging not just as a dark horse but as a potential candidate for chief ministership. Next 48 hours critical. Sahil Joshi joining us there from Mumbai to give us a sense of what's happening in the Maha battle. One battle though is sorted out. Haryana, the state has got its first non-Jat chief minister in 18 years since Bhajan Lal ruled the state. Manohar Lal Khattar, an unassuming Sangh veteran, will be the first saffron chief minister of the state. It took the BJP legislative party meet in Chandigarh all of just 20 minutes, a one-line statement to declare Khattar the chief minister, and the swearing-in ceremony is now slated for 11 a.m. on Sunday. He's considered close to Narendra Modi and had been summoned to manage elections in Varanasi and earlier had worked on post-quake Bhuj.